Corre, corre. Madre, es sucio esa madre, ¿no?
No mames, ¿dónde? Te juro que allá, atrás del poste algo me tocó, cabrón.
¿Dónde está?
Ya, pero no dejes de grabar, güey. No dejes de grabar, cabrón. Velo, güey.
No mames.
Ya lo vieron, güey.
No mames.
Vámonos.
Del. Den, den, den. Before I present you this story, I need to introduce you to this. This is probably the most important case ever, what you are just going to watch. Why? Because there is physical evidence that can be used to prove that this case is real. In November 30th, 2005, I went to Mérida, Yucatán. I had a presentation there. We were making an investigation with our friends in Mérida, the investigators, Emilio Set and Gustavo Alemán. And we were taking dinner the night before, very late, 11 o'clock, and they said, "Have you seen the video that is running from cellular to cellular?" And I said, "No, I haven't. Do you want to see it?" "Well, I mean, it's probably one more video." "No, no, Jaime, you can see an extraterrestrial." And I said, "What? Can you tell me?" And then we have to go around Mérida. We found one young man who had this video around 12:30, 1 o'clock in the morning. He allowed me to make a copy through his cellular to my cellular. I took this to a computer, and I blew it up, and I saw exactly what it is. I was very impressed. Next morning, first thing, 8 o'clock in the morning, I went to the place. I found exactly the exact place where this happened. I found, when I was making the investigation there, the actual witnesses of the case, Jose Alonso Herrera and David Espada. This, I didn't know them, and they were there. The first thing I asked, "Is this case real?" And they said, "Yes, this case is real. We don't know what it is. Was this a joke that made someone to you?" "No, it's not a joke. We don't know about the joke." Then I presented this case first in Mérida, then in Mexico City, in the national television. After I presented it, the case was taken to the front page of the second largest paper in Mexico, Milenio. And they said they made fun of Maussan. These young kids declare that all this was a joke. I talked to them and I said, "Did you declare this?" And they said, "No, nobody has come to see us. This is a complete lie. They are attacking us now and we haven't talked to anyone." It means that the media made up this story to discredit this incredible video. Everybody in Mexico is talking about it. You know, they dedicated editorials to this video, saying Jaime Maussan deserves it. They made fun of him. He deserves this. Finally, somebody did it. Jesus Christ. We've been waiting for this for so long. Finally, somebody got him, you know, by the throat. And then I said to the paper, "No. They made fun of you, not me, you." "No, it's not true." "No, talk to the witnesses." And they had to talk to the witnesses, and the witnesses say, "It's true. Everything you wrote is a lie." And they have to say it in the newspaper. For the first time then, they have to take it. Instead of making fun of me, they were making fun of them. More important than anything else, more important, I found a scientist a scientist who is, who has taken readings in the place and who has found energy levels. Well, let me present first the video and then we talk about it.
This is the video taken by the cellular phone video camera.
Watch the pulse in the left, in the back.
The hour 2 o'clock in the morning. Two boys playing with the pole. Then, look what is going to appear there. There.
No mames, ¿dónde? Te juro que allá, atrás del pozo algo me tocó, cabrón. Ya, pero no dejes de grabar, güey.
This is the second zoom.
No dejes de grabar, cabrón.
And look.
Vino, güey. No mames. Ya lo vieron, güey. No mames.
Now look closely.
Once again. There.
No mames, ¿dónde? Te juro que allá, atrás del pozo algo me tocó, cabrón. Ya, pero no dejes de grabar, güey.
And then it shows again. There.
Vino, güey.
Now in slow motion, look. Look at the head, now the arm, now it's going to take, now it's taking the arm of the boy, now he's pulling the boy to him.
Trying to pull him.
And he stops.
And
the size of the arm is more than 1 meter and 10 centimeters. Now it's clearer.
This is an enhanced, contrasted version. This is the frame still, where you can see the length of the arm.
Here.
A bald head. And also you can see that you cannot see legs. So it seems that it's floating. It gives the impression that it's behind the pose, but it's not behind the pose. It's just a short, more far from the lamppost. However, we don't know if it's floating, if it appears from nowhere.
I don't know. It doesn't matter. What it matters is what it matters is that a scientist took an instrument, a Geiger, and he record very high radiation in the place. Very high frequency radiation and very low frequency radiation. So low that is unheard of. Or so high that is unheard of. 49 rodgens. Rodgens?
Rodgens.
Per hour, I think, or per minute. I don't know. So somebody knows it's very, very high. They took rocks, plants, and even some parts of the post to a laboratory because the radiation was as high or higher than Chernobyl. Okay. They were scared, but they found that the plants, the rocks, and everything there didn't have the radiation in it. Then they took the Geiger again, and they found the same energy there. What proves that the energy is just there floating. It's in the space. It's like a hole in the space. And this is why this is probably the most important case ever. Because any scientist can go there now with a Geiger counter and have exactly the same readings. The energy is still there since March the 20th, the same level. It hasn't reduced a bit. For that reason, I challenge any scientist, any American crew, any media that wants to go there and take the special equipment and measure there.